That's Money all Brown, right, Aaron Smith Jr. That boy Money Brown, he get a lot of money, so I call him Money Brown.
What's good, Money Brown TV? What up, what up?
Yeah.
Shout out to Money Brown TV. Thank you so much for
yo, what's going on out there, fight world? This your boy Money back with another one, man. And this one here is on the 8th Division World Champion and the current WBA Super Welterweight World Champion and Manny Pac-Man Pacquiao and the 4th Division World Champion and Mikey Angel Garcia. You know, Mikey let everybody know that Pacquiao was his next opponent. You know, this man right here, 8th Division World Champion, a legend in the sport. You know what I mean? Somebody that did some shit that probably won't never be duplicated ever again in boxing. You know, it's his next opponent. You feel me? And, you know, we all know we want to see Manny fight Earl. We want to see Manny fight Bud. But I'm going to talk about this fight. You know, Manny Pacquiao went to Dallas to scout Mikey and Earl. And I think he went there hoping that Mikey has some type of success to where he can get it on with Mikey. I don't know if he really wanted to fight Earl Spence or not. You did? But look, Manny Pacquiao has did so much in the sport, man, that he can, you know, pick and choose whom he want to fight. And if this the man right here, Mikey Garcia, who just beat Jesse Vargas at 147 pounds, you know, he only fought at 147 twice, lost to Earl Spence by a milestone, and then he go beat Jesse Vargas in a competitive fight. You know what I mean? At 147, I don't knock him. He got the W, did what he was supposed to do. I'm not going to knock Manny, man. You know what I'm saying? And tell you the truth, I like Mikey Garcia. I like him. To be real with it and serious, I always been a fan of Mikey Garcia. You know, it's just when he came to Earl, I knew he wasn't going to beat Earl. You know, he beat Bronner, he beat Robert Easton. And, you know, he had to go. He had to get knocked off that hill. But Mikey, he's a hell of a fighter. You can't take nothing away from him. He's a 4th Division World Champion. And that's something you got to respect. You know what I mean? And then we got this guy right here, Manny Pacquiao, who's just a fucking monster. You know, I give him his credit as well. Like I say, the man won titles in 8 fucking divisions, regardless if we want to praise it or give him his credit or not. That shit is unheard of. You know what I'm saying? So if this dude, you know, say, you know what, I want Mikey Garcia next, I'm gonna tell you like this, it's better than some damn Conor McGregor. It's better than Conor McGregor. You know, and I'm gonna respect the fight game. You know, it's not a bad fight. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna respect the fight game. But you know, Manny, he still got something in the tank. Like I say, he beat Keith Thurman, took the WBA super up off of Keith Thurman. You know, that was impressive to me. That was impressive. You know, like I say, Mikey came up to 147, daring to be great, taking on Earl Spence Jr. A lot of people try to shit on that win for Earl, but listen, I don't care what you guys say, Mikey was on the pound for pound list. He was beating everybody ass, dominating them, destroying them up to that point, you know, and Earl just stopped the horse. But he got it back on his shit, and he went in there with Jesse Vargas, and, you know, he got a W, bro. If I'm not mistaken, he dropped Jesse. He dropped Jesse. You know, I know people gonna say, well, Jesse ain't this, Jesse ain't that. Listen, I don't care, man. Jesse is a formidable opponent. He went in there and gave Bronner a tough fight, and Mikey went in there and got the job done. You know what I'm saying? That's all you can do is go in there and get the job done. You know? But looking at him and Manny Pacquiao, right? It's not a bad fight. It's not. The only thing is we all pissed off because we know that Earl and Pac must have been getting it on. I wanted Pac for Earl. We all know that's a legacy fight. We all know whoever fight Manny Pacquiao go get a big ass bag. You know, you come to the PBC side and you gotta fight the PBC dudes. You gotta fight the PBC dudes. You fought Bronner, you fought Thurman. Keep it going. You know what I'm saying? But Mikey is a free agent. Mikey signed a 2-fight thing with the zone, well, with Matchroom and the zone, where I know he went over there and fought once, and if they can match the offer that's being given to him, you know, then he got to fight on them for the second time. You see what I'm saying? That's the Eddie Hearn little slick shit he be doing. But nonetheless, man, looking at Mikey and Pacquiao, when I look at the fight, you know, a lot of people like to say, oh, Pacquiao ain't that big. You know, he can still make 140. He can still do this. Bob Arum tried to suck the man down to 135 for Lomachenko. So, you know, they still thinking Manny can make certain weights at under 147 pounds. But nonetheless, I think this fight will be at 147 pounds. Like I say, Manny is the current 147-pound WBA Super World Champion. And Mikey Garcia probably want to become world champion at 147 to try to make him a 5-division world champion. But the fight in itself, I like it. I like it. I'd be lying if I sit up here and say, oh, I think Mikey and Pac is some bullshit. No, even though I won't Pac to fight fucking Earl Spence, yes, I will come out and say I want him to fight Earl Spence. I feel like Earl deserved that shot. I feel like he do. And if Pac knock out Mikey Garcia or somehow beat Mikey Garcia, I think it's probably still a possibility that he do fight Errol Spence. But that's just me and my wishful thinking. But I'd be lying if I say I don't give Mikey a chance in this fight. You know what I'm saying? I do give Mikey a chance to beat Manny Pacquiao. Mikey is a hell of a boxer. He can box when he wants to. Mikey do got some pop. You know what I'm saying? Now, his pop at 147 ain't going to be the same pop as 135 and 130. You know what I'm saying? Even at 126. But nonetheless, I give him credit. He got some pop. He dropped Jesse Vargas. And I ain't saying Jesse got the strongest chin or nothing like that. But at the end of the day, when you dropping big motherfuckers, you got some pop. You know? So, when we look at the fight, I think Mikey more technical than Manny Pacquiao. You know, Pac more busier. Pac more stronger. You know, he ain't the Pacquiao of old, but shit, he's still a damn good Manny Pacquiao. You know what I'm saying? He can bang it out with your ass. And if you slip up, like Thurman in the first round, your ass would be looking up talking about, how did this old motherfucker put me down here? Ain't this about a bitch? And if you fuck up, your ass would be laid out flat, waking up in the motherfucking hospital room talking about, God damn. You understand me? But it's a formidable fight, man. As a boxing fan, you know, I like it. Like I say, I'm not going to hate on nobody getting their paper, and I'm not going to hate if Manny Pacquiao pick Mikey Garcia, because Pacquiao earned the right to fight whom he want to fight. Even though our preference would be Errol Spence. You know, I'd rather him fight Bud over Mikey Garcia. I feel like Bud deserved a fight. How long he been over there with Top Rank? How Bob Arum been hiding this fight from Terrence Bud Crawford? Because he knows this fight would have put Bud on top. He knows that. What that boy said in The Godfather, Johnny Fertain never gets that part. It'll make him a star. You know what I mean? He got his ass Johnny Fertain. That's just real. But like I say, Pacquiao earned the right to pick and choose whom he want to fight, man. And we all know that. It's like the Floyd effect. It's like the Floyd effect. That's why I don't rate Pac like in the pound for pound. I don't rank Pac in the 147 pound division, because I feel like he's above all that. And that's just me giving respect. You know, we know he the cash cow. If you fight him, you win on pay-per-view. You're going to make a nice-ass bag. You know, if you beat him, you're making history. You're beating a legend. You're putting Manny Pacquiao on your resume. You know, you're putting him on your resume. If you beat him decisively. If you beat him in a fashion where people can say, yeah, he beat the shit out of Manny Pacquiao. He deserved that win. Now, I'm not knocking Jeff Horn for his win over Manny Pacquiao. He won. That's history for him. Nobody can take that from him. He became a world champion. He will forever be in the history book as a world champion for beating Manny Pacquiao. But for somebody over in America, you know what I'm saying, that's on the pound for pound list, like a Errol Spence, like a Bud Crawford, even like a Mikey Garcia. If you're going down, you beat Manny Pacquiao decisively. If you beat him, how Marquez beat him. And I know Manny Pacquiao got multiple losses on his resume. But I'm talking about for these young bulls. If they beat him like Marquez beat him, knock his ass out. Oh, man. What it do for them right now, it take them to another level, man. It take them to another level. And that's crazy to say that a man in his 40s, like Manny Pacquiao, can take you to that next level, but it's just a fact. It's just a fact, especially when you're talking about fighting on pay-per-view and making money. You dig what I mean? Especially when you're talking about fighting on pay-per-view and making money, you know? But overall, I know a lot of people might not like the fight. I know a lot of people might be like, Mikey Garcia haven't done shit at 147 to deserve the fight. But Mikey Garcia deserved the fight because of his name. And he still has his fan base. And Mexican versus the Philippines, well, Mexico versus the Philippines, you know, would they like it? Now, I mean, we already know about Marquez and the Pacquiao rivalry. You dig? Barrera and Pacquiao. You know what I'm saying? Morales and Pacquiao. So, would they accept Garcia and Pacquiao? You feel me? See, these are things we got to look at when we look at how they factoring in this fight and how they trying to make the paper. You dig? It's all about the consumer. It's all about trying to get the money. It's all about running up the revenue and TV ratings. You dig? And they going to make sure they look at the business side before a motherfucker sign a contract or make a fight happen. And that's what we got to start understanding and looking at. And sometimes we got to respect this shit, even if we don't agree. You know what I mean? Even if we don't agree. You know what I mean? But like I say, the fight itself, I don't think it's a bad fight. I don't think it's a fight where people are watching to be like, oh, that was some bullshit. I feel like you'd be like, okay, it was an entertaining fight. Mikey ass went in there and fought. You know what I'm saying? Him and Pac, they did what they had to do. Like I say, I edged Pacquiao in the fight, but I damn sure give Mikey Garcia a shot because of his technical style and his counterpunching ability. You know? But we seen his ass go down. We seen his ass get beat for 12 rounds. You know? But could Pacquiao go in there and stop Mikey Garcia? Could he go in there and hit his ass with something that make Mikey say, God damn, I wish I never took this fight? Or could Mikey go in there and use his technical ability to work off his jab, you know, try to get to the body of Manny, slow the pace down, and try to outbox his ass, and hopefully land one of them shots that can put him down, that can put you up on a course, that can edge you to fight? Because I don't see Mikey knocking out Pac. It's a possibility, but I don't see him knocking out Pac. But he can damn sure maybe try to box his way to a win. Box his way to a win and try to land a shot to put Pac down. But, you know, like I say, I'm not mad at the fight if it was to happen. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I told you, I'd rather see him fight Errol Spence. Or I'd rather see him fight Turnbull Crawford, because I believe Crawford deserved a fight as well. You did? But I want to know y'all thoughts on this fight, man. Do y'all like it? Are y'all pissed off? Do y'all think Pacquiao should look over Mike, get Earl and Bud a shot? Is it an okay fight to y'all? Like I said, it's better than fucking Conor McGregor. You dig? It's better than Conor McGregor. I seen many Pacquiao say, Floyd, if you want a real fight, fight me. Conor McGregor is this, that, and the third. Same with Canelo. That's a joke, this, that. But then y'all turn around, we hearing y'all name being mixed up with fighting Conor McGregor. Miss me with that bullshit. Miss me with it. I'm not trying to see that shit no more. I'm not trying to see no crossover fights with no UFC and no boxers anymore. That's it. That's it. That's all. Like my dude Batman to say, that's it. That's all. You feel me? Get y'all ass in the ring and fight these fighters, man. Either a young bull, somebody up and coming, somebody that's a world champion. You dig? Fuck all that crossover shit. That was a spectacle. It was a one-time thing. I respected it. I paid for it. I understood it with Floyd and Conor. But not with y'all, man. Not with y'all. So I'm okay with Mikey Garcia and Manny Pacquiao. And I know a lot of brothers ain't gonna like the shit. You know what I mean? And that's y'all right. That's y'all right. But if Manny and Pac wants to get it on, I'm gonna respect the shit as the boxing game. It's a good fight to me. And we'll just see what happened, man. But let me know y'all thoughts on it, man. But until then, this your boy Monty. This the end. As we see moving, anybody safe in these streets, hit them thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel. If you want to donate, OG Monty on Cash App, TreyHampton52@gmail.com on PayPal. If you can't, tell a friend, tell a friend. Hit the subscribe button. Like, comment, share the video. And y'all know how I finish, man. Big dog status. Smoke whatever nigga try to intervene. On a couple beans, need a couple more. Mozzie stamp tatted on a couple dogs. Don't treat me like God.